Well, good evening and welcome once again to For Your Entertainment. My name is Nelson Torres and this is...
MZ Hammer, Nelson. Good to see you again.
Likewise. Now, question. Have you ever draw?
No, I never was an artist.
No?
No.
You never draw any pictures of self, you know, like self-portrait or anything
like
that?
Well, maybe matchstick people.
Oh, matchstick. Well, you know what? Okay, I can understand that. Well, today we're going to have a special guest, and let me tell you, it's very special because some beautiful artwork. And Mike, take
it. Artist extraordinaire and teacher, Mr. Gene Esther, tonight on our show For Your Entertainment. Gene, it's great to see you again.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for having me.
Yeah. Okay, man. Wow, you got big display of your talent here with us. We have a lot to talk about, so let's get it on here.
Okay, first thing off is how long have you been drawing, or what really drew you to this?
Well, this, being an artist, I've been doing it for about like 11 years now, so it's like well into me. I love it. I love teaching. I love
professionally.
Professionally. Okay. When I decided to call myself a professional artist, I think that was the day I was like, all right, I'll count that as the first day. So it was like I was about 25. I kind of stopped in my early days, but I got back into it, and now I do it full time. So it's a pleasure.
And what kind of work do you do? I mean, as far as artistic.
Well, a little bit of everything. I paint. Good. I draw. I work with clients. I do logos. I do portraits. I do events. I do a lot of community events, things like that. I really like to work with the community I'm in and to help inspire kids. So I do a lot of teaching as well. So that's, I do a little bit of everything because art is it's my passion, really.
Is that one of your purposes then for all this, is to help people?
Yeah, you can say that. Like inspiring people, that's really my calling. You know, when I really look at it, it's really looking at people seeing what I do and the fact that I love it and I'm passionate about it.
Yes.
So people get inspired by that. So
and it isn't just canvas work either, too. Because, by the way, he did do our video.
Yeah, he did. This is the man who did our promo for our show. And I had many compliments, Gene, that it's fabulous.
Thank you
so much for helping us out on that venue.
No, not it's a pleasure. It's a pleasure. Yeah, I love doing videos. Videos is like a way to capture what I do and my students and anything that I do around art. I like to make videos with it. And it promotes the art.
Absolutely.
And the artist. So, I love doing videos. And, thanks for having me do it for you guys. So.
Yes. It was a pleasure. Yeah. Believe me, after the end result, I was like, wow, we got to have this guy in there. That's pretty good.
If you'd like to call in, Nelson, the number is?
It's 610-378-0426.
Call in and talk to Gene, and we're going to talk about what you have here now.
Yeah,
Gene.
All right.
So pick up a magazine there or whatever you got there. And
what is exactly
what you got here?
Well, first I'm going to show you guys a series of books that I either illustrated or created.
Okay.
And it's a huge honor. So first let me start with a book that I created with two good friends of mine, Bruce Jones and D.L. Nusky. And we created our own comic book, and this book was about my character called Akin. And it's basically a story about my character, how I discovered my powers from within me, and I started to help awaken others to their true potential.
Wow.
So the idea for Metasabian is basically turning real people into superheroes.
Okay.
So it's actually a project that I'm still working on. It's just a big project, and it takes a while to produce. So it's a huge honor to kind of create something you love. When I was a kid, I wanted to create my own comic book. So.
Cool.
When I got older, I got a chance to, and I did it. Yeah.
You're still a kid.
Oh, yeah. At heart. Always. Always. Oh, I'm never going to. Hey.
Yeah.
Is that something for sale now?
Yes.
And where can someone get something?
Actually, rumeta.com right there is the website. I also created the website because I do web hosting and web creation. So I created a website for Metasabian, so people can actually order the book, issue one or issue two.
Cool.
And then I also have the latest one that I put out, which is Metasabian, the collector's edition. So basically all three books in one. And this is a project that I worked on years ago, back in 2011. And now I have a product that I can always offer to people, and something that I created, something that's independent. And I like to promote that because a lot of people can do that. Nowadays, you can actually create your own product and promote it as independent. And
yeah, the way you can today, everyone in the world can see it.
Social media. The world changed with social media. You know, you just got to share with people what you do and show that you're passionate about it. And you will you can become an artist just like that because people discover you and they like your work. Yeah.
And this one, you illustrated and you wrote it, or?
Yep, mostly a lot of illustration, and my partners helped me write it. They did some drawing as well, so it was a learning process for all of us. I never painted or did a lot of things, but that's why I put it all together in this book. It's a great concept, and I want people to join too, be a part of it, and become a Meta.
And once again, how can they join?
If you go to my website, artcorner.net or rumeta.com, you can either check out the book, you can read up on the project and what we're doing.
Okay.
And you can see some of the videos that we created also. It's a cool way to promote, like I
said. There's
a
card up there.
There it is. That's it. Yep. Art Corner. Yeah, that's the way that I offer my art services to people.
Okay.
You know, I want it to be professional. I want it to have, you know, people to take me seriously as an artist. So you have to do a serious thing, like create a website and promote it a lot, you know, like, and that's what I do in my social medias.
Okay, now, this is going to be tough. But I want you to explain to us, what do we have here as far as the pictures and everything?
Oh, the paintings, yeah.
Yes. Start off with one of them, Jim.
All right, sure. I'll show you guys I think this one's one of the my favorites. This is part of my Human Nature series called, I think this one is called Birds and Fit. No, actually this is Gaia. Yeah, this is the globe. So there's a lot of meaning behind it. If you look at each eye, they're a particular animal. One's a fish to represent the water, and the other one's the birds represent the sky. And we got to be, and it's all about being conscious, seeing through the eyes of the animals of what's going on, what we're doing to our planet. And there's a lot of hidden symbolism in here. Like this is like uranium, you know, from Fukushima. Like there's trash in the water. There's a lot of concepts in here that I wanted to put out. And
so it's an awareness picture you thought of?
It's an awareness. It's something that I care about a lot. I do love nature, and I love things like
the
that.
The minute I looked at that, it reminded me of something that Earth, Wind, and Fire would do.
Wow.
In the pictures, you know, in
for
the
sure.
background. Because that's how they did it.
Yeah.
And they created a lot of the messages in the painting itself.
Yeah, you can see it. See, that's the Earth right there. There's a heart shape of the planet Earth. There's a sun there. Inside the heart, you know, little hidden gems, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. so you can kind of.
But when you put it all together, it becomes a beautiful artwork right in there.
Wow, look, it looks fabulous on TV.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
I mean,
intense,
absolutely
right?
fabulous.
Intense. We could talk hours about this one.
Yeah,
so I have a few
that.
More. I have a few more.
That one definitely an Earth,
yeah,
Wind, and Fire.
Yeah, this one up front. Yeah, this is. I like this one. This one.
That one definitely an Earth, Wind, and Fire.
Oh, for sure, man. See, you
now, is that King Tut there or what?
Yeah, this one. I believe it's. I believe it is King Tut on this one. Yeah, this
King
is King Tut.
Tut.
Yeah, okay. And this is the called the Pharaoh's Mask.
Okay.
And I love just the ornate classic things that exist in history. So I do love Egyptian history. So I kind of looked it up, researched, and I love this mask. So I painted it and I gave it my own like kind of twist to it, but it does have a very realistic approach to it. So I want it to shine. I want it to glow amongst mm-hmm. the dark background.
Mm-hmm. And this looks like gold.
Yeah, definitely. This was actually part of the last art show that I was part of, the Dimension show, Light and Dark, and it was a great event.
So what makes this one different than the other King Tut's pictures that you see?
Not much. You know what? It's about execution. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
It's really the concept that I wanted. I wanted it very clean and very simple.
Oh, yeah.
So this one wasn't more of an approach like this, where I had to draw this, design it, really come up with the hidden gems, put it together, kind of do it like that. Mm-hmm. This one was more of a classical approach. Just give it a beautiful, good golden look.
You're actually showing your styles,
right?
Because
it's all about styles.
Yeah, believe me,
it's all about styles.
All
even
about
if you, even in my artwork, there's a lot mm-hmm. of different styles. Because
it's not complicated on the other one, but in this
right.
one, it's real smooth.
Yeah, and it's all about the approach.
Yes.
I completely had to do something different for this one compared to this one. This
right.
one was like my classical approach. It's almost like looking at a still life. Mm-hmm. You know, you just want to look at it, give it, you know, find all the minute changes. The details, bring it together.
And the next one.
All right, this
Can
one.
Can I interrupt you there?
Yeah,
first?
Sure.
So we're going to show one of the videos, Joan, if you could.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
The first one. Yeah.
All right,
the first video. Check out some of your work here.
All right. great way to spend the evening, you know?
Cool.
Yeah, I love it. Yeah, definitely. So
you have fun doing this.
Yes.
Well,
yes.
Look at him smiling.
Yeah, but that's what I mean. Hey, I love when people enjoy
it. He's loving it, talking about it. And yeah, that's his passion.
That's my passion, so you
that's
feel it.
Passion.
Yeah, it's not like I have to try, because it's literally, I mean, mm-hmm. I for a living, I do art, and I inspire people to do art, and I teach art, so it makes your life kind of fulfilling. I teach seniors. Yeah, I teach seniors also. Creativity. Yeah, mm-hmm. Big time.
And the last picture.
All right, this one.
That thing's been staring at me, Gene. I'm scared.
Yeah, this one.
It's gonna jump out of that picture.
Tiger's Gaze. One of my favorites, because I love it because it's huge. It's a big painting. It's a big painting. It's 36x48, and I wanted again another approach of like really having something taking over a space. And when something stares at you, you know, you can't help but stare back. You know what I mean? So
yeah.
Tiger's Gaze, actually, it's hard to see, but the eyes are gold and copper. So there's a metallic approach to it. Everything else was done in acrylic and a little bit of oils over. Mm-hmm. And just, you know, creating, you know, again, using, and then also with, you notice about the colors on the bottom, right?
The bottom.
Yeah, it's almost like
it's coming out of the water.
Right, okay. Right. You know, I would run
at this moment.
Yeah, but you know what? I mean, the threat, who's threatened? Maybe he's just afraid of you, you know?
That's the whole thing. You can see it. It's looking at you. It's like, okay, you're looking at me.
Yeah, and I'm looking at you.
So I'm looking at you. Right. So what's the next move? Yeah.
They could have used that for Rocky III, Eye of the Tiger.
That's a good one.
All right, I do have a few other pieces.
All right,
I got a few more,
okay,
but before I forget, this is the all-important one. For those, you know, who don't know who I am, I do a lot of illustration. I work with a lot of people, and one of the great people I had the pleasure to work with is Wally Scott, all right? So he's our mayor.
That's our mayor.
If you don't know, he's our mayor, and I worked with him on two books. He is a great writer. I don't know if you guys know that. And he also loves Christmas.
Beautiful.
And so
you designed everything here.
Yeah, I illustrate. I mean, we worked
the
on
cover, everything.
The cover, the art style. Wally wanted a specific style, and I delivered, and it was a great book. So The Carpenter Who Saved Christmas is an awesome Christmas book that he wrote and I illustrated, and it was a huge honor. And I think a lot of people in the city do have these, because actually Wally gives these out
every
Christmas.
Okay, in his office?
Yeah, in his office.
They come up
for Christmas.
To talk to Wally, he says, hey.
Yeah, he probably
can you sign this for me, Wally?
Yeah, why not? He will probably sign it. He's that impressionable.
He
can walk up to the man and he says hello to everyone. He's
and
awesome.
This is like a welcome him.
Right.
With it.
Okay.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. And then the second book is The Children's Tree. And this one's an awesome book, because actually he puts his children in the book. So this is Kylie, and it's an awesome, awesome book that talks about homeless children and what they did to make an amazing Christmas for them, not only them, but their entire neighborhood. And it's a great story. So Wally Scott is a phenomenal like mayor and writer, really. He does amazing stuff. So
awesome.
Worked on that with him. And I have a few more paintings.
Okay.
All right. So this
Once again, I just wanted to interrupt and say that you are watching For Your Entertainment with MZ Hammer and Nelson Torres and Mr. Gene Esther.
That's right. Thank you, sir.
It's
a pleasure. It is a pleasure, guys. Hey, this is a great.
This is fascinating.
Yeah.
Look
great.
At this.
Oh, man. If we had more time, I'd show you guys how to really, you know.
This one is, I really like this one.
He would have liked to paint tonight, Nelson, but he just didn't have the time to do
Absolutely.
It with our show.
Hey, never know.
Next time.
We might do it again, definitely.
Yeah.
So, this is a classic. This is actually my Facebook picture, right?
Yes,
I've kept it down
for
years.
This is the one I put on.
And also, it also promotes, my graphic novel, right?
Now, is that some kind of metal man then?
Yeah. This is my superhero form, my meta form. You know, so I created my comic book to help inspire people to find their superhero within, right?
And it's just a self-portrait.
Yeah, it's a self-portrait. Yeah, there you go. Okay. Keeping it simple. You know, a little bit, you know, I got a little bit of more muscle there. It's a great piece, and I love, and this is my character, Ken. So this is actually what I use for my cover as well. So this is one of my awesome pieces. And what else? I have, this is one of my favorites too, a classic one. A lot of people,
tell us about that one.
This one, Native American Chief. Very simple piece. I wanted something with a little bit of fantasy and reality to it, too. So I kept it monochromatic which is just simple colors, two colors, mm-hmm. three colors actually, and highly rendered. I did this in oils, and I just wanted to kind of give homage to the Native Americans, you right. know, the original. So, and I actually, this is part of a series of pieces that I look at all the just Native people from mm-hmm. all parts of the world, and I'm just trying to kind of do that. I did a Nubian one, and I actually have videos of how I painted the process on my website. So,
and yeah. where'd you get that inspiration for that?
From a few things. I looked at a few pictures, right? But then there was also this a statue, right? There was a statue that had, and that's where I got most of the face.
Okay,
and
from a statue.
Arm. Yeah, the statue was awesome. Great angle, and it gave me a lot of the rendering aspects. But then I added a few other things. I added extra feather and just got kind of made it on, and I just kind of left the back so I can kind of create a design where the the hatchet or the machete kind of
again
lays
one in. Of the things that I like to emphasize is like if you look at each picture and you see the difference between each one, you know the creativity that comes at you and at the moment
for sure,
and then it makes you wonder wow, did I do that?
I do that to myself. It's the awe sensation. Right, when that happens to you, you gotta because you're pushing yourself to really
absolutely
when I constantly try to learn something new
absolutely.
Where I don't know anything and I have to kind of go through all my mistakes, and then once you have it, you get good at it. The more you do it, and matter of fact, once you teach it, you know it better, because then you can transfer that information to someone's mind, and they can do it too. It makes you even better. So that's why
teaching,
I teach.
Right?
Teaching.
Yeah, what's that video that we have you for?
Yeah, let's show the other video, Joan, if you would, please.
Teaching.
Yes.
Can you explain that? The teaching.
Teaching. Yes. At Studio B in Bordertown. So I also teach privately, but my main students are there. They just. It's a great place to kind of establish myself, Bordertown, and the students are fantastic. I've been teaching there for over like 9 years, I think now, and it's just been just as long as my career. Yeah, I started teaching, and I figured out that oh my
is
god,
is there an age for that?
Kids and teens. Kids and teens are welcome. Okay. I teach abroad, and pretty much my philosophy is a studio where it's not what I teach them, it's what they want to do, and I give them ideas, tricks, and just...
You can show the video now?
Yeah.
Hey, how's it going, everyone? Gene Esther with ArtCorner.net. Back again with another fantastic video at Studio B. All right, guys, it was another fantastic week as always. Check out my students' amazing work. Guys, that's all I have for this week. As always, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. More from myself, Gene Esther, with ArtCorner.net, and my amazing students at Studio B. Take care, everyone.
So not only does he create the art itself, he produces the video so that people can see what he created.
Right.
And that is really, really like an awesome, awesome talent.
Yes.
You know, it's very hard, and you're using your talent to help others
Yes.
as well.
Yes.
And
right.
That's what we like to see, you know. We like to bring out people with art, you know, any artistic talents or anything that they
have. Yeah.
But we also like them to see and help others.
And there's rookies that have no idea how to paint, and they come right to you, and you teach them.
Yeah, well, yeah.
There's
yeah.
no...
Well, there is a creative... ability in everyone,
right.
you know. I mean, an engineer, a scientist, all these. It's a creative process of observing and then doing something with your hands or your
bring
mind,
it out.
And you bring it out. It's all. I work with musicians and I help them bring it out. It's if you're working next to someone that's being Like they're drawing, it makes you want to do something creative too.
Music is really both together, because if you notice that a lot of artists use music to draw, and vice versa.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, that's why I have music in my video. I love music and art. Visual arts, audio. That's what a video is, you know, audio visual. So when you see audio and visuals together, it grabs you. So just as it's like a commercial. You can promote yourself with videos by being honest on social media and sharing what you do. And that's what got me to where I am now. Mm-hmm. I mean, a lot of people know who I am because of my videos, and it works.
How do you pronounce your name?
Jean Esther.
In French?
Jean Richard Esther.
There you go.
There you go.
And you have him here at the For You Entertainment. And Mike, is there anything you want to
do? You got anything else here? Jean, did you show us everything?
I believe so. I mean, all I can bring. I have so much more.
But and if anybody wanted to reach you, where would they go?
Yeah, if you check out artcorner.net, and you will find all my information there, or you can see me on Facebook, Jean Esther. I'm on Twitter, Instagram. Mm-hmm. It's all over. So I'm on all social media. If you check out my website, artcorner.net, you'll definitely be able to get in touch with me, okay?
How about events? Do you got any big events coming up as far as shows?
Events, yes. I'm actually
talk about that.
At Studio B, I plan on having a show in March for my students, and all the students that I work with, some past and present are gonna come, and we're gonna do an amazing show with all the things that we can put together. I'm gonna let the students work this so they can understand how it is to kind of create a show. So it's gonna be a huge thing. So next year,
who can come to the show?
Everybody's
welcome.
Everybody's welcome. Well, if you keep in touch, if you see me on Facebook, I will be promoting it. I'll be kind of sharing things as things get closer. But definitely next year is gonna be great for not only myself but for my students. Mm-hmm. And I look forward to it. Definitely.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, there you have it, Gino Arstein.
Yes.
But here at For You Entertainment with Michael or MZ Hammer and Nelson Torres. Anything else you want to add, Mike?
How long did it take you to realize that you were an artist?
At a young age, just
young age.
Yeah,
already.
Just you know, when people call you the class artist and things, it kind of gets you groomed to that level. But if you enjoy doing something.
I mean, you sat down one day and you painted a fabulous picture. Is that how it worked, or did you have to work at it?
No,
some people just doodled when they were sitting in school. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
I doodled a lot. It was a lot of doodling.
So it started way before that. It started in school then.
Yes.
Somewhere out there is an artist who's ready to begin. What do you tell them?
Yes.
I say, do it. Just draw. If you like to, if you want to draw, draw. If you want to paint, get some paint set, a basic paint set. If not, find ways to just do the art the way that you like it, because that's what makes develops you as an artist. The more you do something, the better you get at it. So it's just doing it for the pleasure of it, for the fun of it, and do it early, because a successful artist, it has a better success when they start young. When you learn to be professional young, do it for free when you're young, and it's harder when you're older. So you have to kind of develop your network, get familiar, be able to stand out and say, hey, this is who I am, this is my art, and it'll happen. It's just a matter of doing it and being brave and getting away from the thoughts that say that you can't do it. So it's all possible. It's within everyone. We can all do this. This is nothing new.
Gene, it's been a pleasure.
Yes.
Thank you for being on our show.
Yes, it has.
Thank you, guys. It's a pleasure. Thank you.
And stay tuned for Hair to Toe Beauty Test, because he's not going anywhere.
I'm not going anywhere. There's more. There's more to me, guys. There you go.
So we thank you for watching. And this is, again, Nelson Torres, MZ Hammer, and Gene Esther. We thank you for watching. And take care. We'll see you the next time on For You Entertainment.
See you next time, everybody.